just say that we have a reference frame XYZ, and let us keep this reference frame at some point O. At some point O, we'll be coming to the specification of point O little later. So we have a reference frame, unspecified reference frame at point O, at an unspecified point till now. Now, with respect to this reference frame, let us suppose that the angular velocity of this rigid body is expressed in terms of the scalar components. I mean to say, it is expressed like omega x, omega y, and omega z. So this angular, because we require this coordinate system in order to explicitly express this angular velocity vector of the body. So far, as I have already, I reiterate that these XYZ coordinate systems are unspecified. And till now, the point O where I have kept the origin of this reference frame is unspecified. But let us now say something about point O. Now, what is point O? The point O is either a fixed point about which the body is rotating. So you see, therefore, that the point O that we are considering here is either a fixed point about which the body is rotating. That means this rigid body is rotating about this fixed point. That can be a case, or it is the center of mass of the body. So either we have this is a fixed point, and not only that it is the fixed point, but also we say that this is a point of rotation. That means the rigid body is rotating about a point, right? Either that would be the case, or we consider this to be the center of mass. This point O can be considered as the center of mass of the body. Okay. Now, once I write this expression from here, I see that let us consider an arbitrary point. Let us consider an arbitrary point here and say this arbitrary point is containing this differential mass dm. Right. So we consider a differential mass dm over here, and let us suppose that this point is having the position vector with respect to this point O, which is a fixed point or is the center of mass. So with respect to this, let us say that this is our position vector, say xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. That represents the position vector of this mass dm. So once this is done, we can say that the relative angular momentum, in fact,
sir, ekbar ektu dekhun sir, tomoji to dhukte pachche na mone hoy, ektu dekhun.
Okay, Obhishek Kumar ache, tomoji to ekhono dekhchi na, Gaurav Ghosh, Tomojit Poddar. Okay, thank you. Hariom Sharon, Sayon Devnath. Okay. So you see, therefore, that if we consider here, in fact, you know that in order to find out this, we need not be so specific that this will be either a fixed point or the center of mass of the body. We need not be so specific. It can be any arbitrary point, right? But why we are specifying this? Because later we require some, the definition, some development of this angular momentum equation. There we will require this kind of specification of the point O. So you may note in your khata that although I am saying that this is a fixed point of rotation or it represents the center of mass of the body, please note in your khata that in order to calculate the relative angular momentum about the point O, the point O need not be only these two points. It can be any arbitrary point here. So in order to define this expression, the point O need not to be the special point as specified here, this or that, right? So it can be any arbitrary point. For that, we can write this equation. But why then we have written this? Because we say that later when we will develop further theories based on this concept of angular momentum, we will require these specifications. So that's why I have written it over here, although this expression can be written if O is any general point on the body, or it may be any point within the system. So if you know, consider consider this point which is having the differential mass. I have its position vector defined by this position vector rho bar over there, and we can say then the relative angular momentum of this point with respect to point O will be what? Since this point O is a fixed point, I mean to say it is the distance between these two is fixed, because it may be considered within the body. The point O may be considered within the body as shown in the figure. In that case, definitely you can say that this is a fixed distance, or it can be lying outside somewhere here. If it lies outside somewhere here, then I can think of that this body is consisting of this massless extension. This is what is termed as the massless extension of the body. So I may consider that our rigid body consists of union of two sets. One set is the original rigid body and another set is the massless extension of the body. So that if I take the union of these two, I may think of a special type of rigid body. So in that case, the distance between O and DM will again be constant. So therefore, the distance, this the magnitude of this position vector rho bar, this is going to be constant. So in that case, if I see what will be the relative angular momentum, then the relative angular momentum will simply depend upon the relative velocity of this mass point with respect to point O. So in that case, what will be the relative velocity? Because I say the distance between this is going to be constant, the relative velocity is just given by this omega bar cross rho bar. That means it is as if it is moving in a circular motion, this dm, with the radius vector rho bar. So as a result, this will be the relative velocity expression. This will be the relative velocity expression. Multiplied with the mass dm, it will give us what is termed as the relative linear momentum. So that relative linear momentum, if we take now the moment of that linear momentum with respect to point O, then it will be rho bar. If we go taking the moment of this linear momentum with respect to point O, then we can say that this will be rho bar cross omega bar cross rho bar dm. And for the entire mass, then I will be having the integration over this entire mass. Now, if the point O lies within the body, then there is no problem of considering this integration. If the point does not lie within the body, it is lying outside, in that case, we say that it is the massless extension. So the integration has to be carried out over both the entire mass. I mean to say from this to this, but virtually saying this, ultimately this will be equal to integration over the entire mass, because as I said, this is the massless extension. So there will be no mass of this thing. So ultimately the integration will be carried out over with respect to the domain which is contained within the body. So even if the point O does not lie within the territory of the body, we can say that it is lying outside. In that case, we consider this artificial body which is having no mass, and the integration has to be performed within the entire domain. Virtually, that will be equal to the integration performed within this physical domain, because this part does not have any mass. So as a result, we have a triple product of the vectors over here, and the triple product of vectors, the equation. That means if I say we have the three vectors, say A bar cross B bar cross C bar, then we know that it will be equal to what? It will be the outer dot remote. That means outer vector dot the remote vector. Here the outer vector is this. This is the remote vector. This is the remote vector, and this is the adjacent vector. So it is outer dot remote of adjacent. So rho bar dot rho bar ultimately makes it rho square. So outer dot remote times adjacent vector. The adjacent vector is omega bar. So it will be rho square omega bar minus it is dot product of outer dot adjacent times remote. That means it will be what? It will be rho bar dot omega bar or omega bar dot rho bar times rho bar. So this is how we can, you know, formulate this vector triple product of this, and we get that we write this equation, we write this equation in this manner. So it is rho square omega bar minus omega bar dot rho bar of rho bar dm. So if I remember, what is rho square? What is rho square? So rho square is nothing but, because as I told you that rho bar is x bar xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. So rho square basically, you know, represent this x square plus y square plus z square times omega bar. So omega x I cap plus omega y j cap plus omega z k cap minus omega bar dot rho bar. So it will be the inner product of that times the rho bar. So that will be the equation. So if you now say carry out this algebra, then what you see from here, you just say it is, say for example, we show the detail of this algebra for the I component. The J component and K component detail will be like similar, and it is not repeated over here for the sake of avoiding the boredom. So that is why we just show the algebra for the I component only. And if I just consider the I component, this will be the algebra. It will be omega x multiplied by this factor minus the I component that will be produced because of these cross products. That will be x into the whole time. So it is x square omega x plus xy omega y plus xz omega z. That will consist of the I component. Similarly, you should write the full expression for j component. Similarly, you should write full expression for k cap component. So if you see, if you distribute this algebra, if you distribute this algebra here, what you will find that it becomes, let me increase the percentage of visualization. So you see from here that what we are saying, ki this algebra, if you go, then the algebra turns out to be something like this. And if you distribute the integral, then what will happen? You see, this can be written as the HO bar real, the relative, this part, it can be written as HOX I cap plus HOY J cap plus HOZ K cap, where X, Y, Z are the unspecified coordinate axes at the unspecified point O. I repeat once again, although I have specified some specification, I have given some specification here from the consideration that we later on require the specification of point O. In fact, for calculating this relative angular momentum with respect to point O, it need not be that point O will be only these two points. For that matter, it can be any point whatsoever about which I can calculate the relative angular momentum about that point. So please, you know, focus on to this. We will require this kind of specification later in part of our study. So rather, you should not say that I can write this equation only about point O which is satisfying these two. So point O can be any specific, any point about which I can write these equations. So only thing, I require a coordinate system to be attached at point O, where the point O is totally unspecified. I repeat, the x, y, z coordinates are also unspecified. That means whether it is rigidly attached at point O or loosely attached, I'm not going into that specification. So it is some reference frame available at point O. So stationed at point O, if I have this, then I can express this in terms of these, you know, the scalar components about those three axes, where we can very easily say that HOX, that means the X component of the relative angular momentum, will be given by omega X integration y square plus z square dm plus, you see now this, there are two minus signs. So you see this is minus this and minus this. So ultimately, you remember, we know that this is IXX. I bring this minus sign out of this integration sign. I bring this minus sign out of the integration, and ultimately making this integration to be the product moment of inertia, and this integration also to be product moment of inertia. But now you just see that we have the minus sign here and the minus sign there. Correct? Similarly, this is the expression for the angular momentum about the x-axis. Similarly, one can go for the angular momentum about the y-axis and angular momentum about the z-axis and satisfy yourself that, that means where those terms I have left, I have left these terms for you, dot, dot, dot terms. I have left this algebra. I leave it for you to complete at your home and satisfy yourself that you will be getting these expressions for the angular momentum about the y-axis and the angular momentum about the z-axis. Now, this is the reason why we put, you remember, in our inertia matrix, we put the minus signs in front of the product moment of inertia terms. And I said that you accept the presence of this minus sign. The reason behind it will be explained later, at that time when I took this class. Why I said that now is pretty clear to you. It is the because of the algebra that we will be getting here, we require this minus signs in front of the product moment of inertia. Because if these three simultaneous equations are expressed in terms of the matrices, then you see the left-hand side will represent a column matrix, and ultimately it represents the angular momentum, relative angular momentum vector calculated with respect to point O, where O is an unspecified point. This will be the inertia matrix available at point O and expressed in terms of unspecified XYZ coordinate system. So we consider some unspecified XYZ coordinate system at point O, and about that unspecified coordinate axis, we just calculate the inertia matrix of the entire rigid body at point O along this XYZ axis. That XYZ axis that you have chosen, about that XYZ axis, you just express your inertia matrix and represent them in this. And then the last one is the, is, you know, this vector. It is this vector which represents what? This represents the angular velocity of the body, absolute angular velocity of the body. Please note that this was the expression. Please note that this was the expression for the absolute angular velocity. See, this was the expression for the absolute angular velocity of the body. So this absolute angular velocity vector is coming on the right hand side. On the left hand side, you have got a vector. So you just see, you have two vectors here on the left hand side and one vector on the right hand side, which are connected by means of, which are connected by means of an inertia matrix over here. So it is a tensor of first order. This is a tensor of first order, which these two tensors of first order are basically connected by tensor of second order. And you are getting this type of, you know, the product that you are getting over here. These are sometimes known as the dyadic product of the vectors, of the tensors. So about which you will learn in your higher subjects. If somebody is interested in the transport phenomena that Shorjo Dipto is attending today's class from the Department of Chemical Engineering, they have a very important subject called transport phenomena. in the transport phenomena, they have the opportunity to discuss, to deal with the scalars, scalar chere dao, they have the opportunity to discuss with the tensors of various quantities, and will come across many sort of tensorial combinations and tensor vector combinations, etc. So you see that we have, this is our expression, this is what it says. It is the angular momentum, angular velocity of the body relationship. This relation, which is saying that the relative angular momentum about some arbitrary point, relative angular momentum about some arbitrary point is expressed as relative angular momentum of the rigid body about some arbitrary point is expressed as, you see, this is the inertia matrix times the angular velocity vector. The above equation is, you know, again, I am, you know, this specifying this, keeping in connection with our future reference of study. Though I said that this can be any arbitrary point, it is still mentioned that the above equation is applicable when angular momentum is calculated with respect to a fixed point about which the body is undergoing the rotational motion or the center of mass of the body. We keep on saying this because we require these two type of specifications later. So that's why we say that this relation is, since the point O is an arbitrary point, so therefore about these two points, about these two points also, we can apply this sort of relationship. So we will particularly have to deal with these two cases. So that is why this specification of the point O, this type of specification of point O is frequently it is coming into our discussion, because we will be requiring this sort of things in our subsequent analysis of our study. Now, the inertia matrix in the above equation needs to be evaluated at point O and in one. That means if this is the case, if the body, suppose if this is the case that the rigid body is rotating about a fixed point, so if O is a point of rotation about which the rigid body is rotating, then we can apply this equation over there. We can apply this equation over there. Remember that it will be the relative angular momentum, and in that case, you see this I needs to be calculated with respect to point O in case one, and it will be case dealt in with respect to point C in case two. That means if case two is the situation when the point is a center of mass of the body. So if point O, that point O, that arbitrary point O in our equation, if this point O represents the center of mass, then we say the center of mass is defined by C. So that's why we say that this needs to be evaluated at the center of mass at point C. So although this equation is valid for any arbitrary point, still yet I keep on repeating this one, it will be the two cases which will be of utmost importance in our subsequent analysis. That's why it is reiterated once again. Now, once this is being done, let us now say, so you see, we consider that we consider the next article. So we found the relative angular momentum about an arbitrary point. Let us now find the angular momentum about an arbitrary point. Now here, the angular momentum means, you should write in your khata that it should be, it is the absolute angular momentum, that we are calculating the absolute angular momentum about an arbitrary point. So here, this word is missing. I just missed this word. It should be written as absolute angular momentum about an arbitrary point of a rigid body. So again, we consider a point A, which is totally arbitrary. This point is shown to be belonging within the physical domain, else this point can be here outside. If the point A is outside, then you require this massless extension of this rigid body so that this becomes also the part of the entire united domain. So if I suppose therefore that we take this point A, now this point A, about this we are going to calculate the absolute angular momentum of the rigid body. So once again I choose this, you know, the differential mass dm. This is the differential mass dm that we have chosen, and you see from here that I take three position vectors from point A to this. We are considering this position vector as r bar. From point A to the center of mass of the body, this is the center of mass of the body. Let us say that the center of mass position vector is r bar bar, and we have the relative position vector. This will be termed as the relative position vector. Relative position vector of the center of, sorry, of this arbitrary differential mass with respect to the center of mass. So this is the relative position vector of this point with respect to the center of mass. And we consider that the, at the instant we are seeing this, at that instant, let us suppose that the center of mass is having the velocity v bar c, and this differential mass is having the velocity v bar. So under such circumstances, if I consider this is the absolute velocity of the center of mass, absolute velocity of this arbitrary mass, absolute velocity of the arbitrary mass, if I consider, then its absolute angular momentum, the absolute angular momentum about point A. So at this point A, we are going to calculate the absolute angular momentum, and in that case, it will be the integration of over the entire domain. If it is lying within the body, it will be the physical domain. If it lies outside the body, then it will be the united domain. Again, that will be ultimately equal to this physical domain, because this is, you know, the massless extension. So you see, therefore, whatever may be your situation, it is the physical domain integration over the physical domain, r bar cross v bar dm, and in place of r bar from this triangle, you can write this will be rho bar plus r bar bar plus this one. Now why it is coming this one, go to yesterday's board work. So you see that same situation is shown over here that I have shown. Now what is the velocity of this arbitrary point on the body? You know that this velocity equation is written in terms of the the known velocity at the center of mass. This is the center of mass of the body. So you see this velocity of the arbitrary point and the velocity of the center of mass, these two are connected by this relationship. So v bar is equal to v bar c plus omega bar body cross rho bar. So if we consider it to be the relative velocity, if I can try to consider the relative velocity of this about the center of mass, if I consider the relative velocity about the center of mass, then we will find that the relative velocity of this thing about the center of mass will be v bar minus v bar c, that will be equal to omega bar body cross rho bar. Now if I do not take the center of mass into our picture, suppose I do not take into account the center of mass into our picture, then what will happen? I will have this rigid body, I will have the arbitrary point moving with a velocity v bar at the instant, and I have an arbitrary point here about which I am going to calculate the angular momentum, say the relative angular momentum. So in that case, the relative angular momentum simply depends upon the omega bar body cross this position vector. So this is the position, this is the relative velocity of this point with respect to point A. And then I will be getting the relative angular momentum of the entire system with respect to point A, the case which we have just now studied, the case that which we have just now studied. So we see therefore, that we can have that, particular thing, concept of what is termed as the relative angular momentum with respect to any arbitrary point. In that case, I need to take into account the relative velocity of this mass with respect to this. But if I take the consideration of the relative angular momentum of this with respect to this, then I need to calculate the relative velocity of this one with respect to this, and that will depend upon this position vector and the angular velocity of the body. Had I gone for this point, then it will depend upon the angular velocity and this position vector of the body. In our previous discussion, this position vector also we defined it by the symbol rho bar. So that could be replaced by r bar as well, no problem. Only thing you have to make your concept very clear. So you see this omega bar body cross rho bar, which is representing the relative velocity of this mass point with respect to the center of mass. This relative velocity is going to be perpendicular to this position vector. So this vector is drawn therefore such that it remains perpendicular with this vector. Okay. So I therefore have, this is the total velocity of this. And since I am going to calculate the absolute angular momentum of the entire body with respect to point A, I need to take the absolute velocity of this mass point. So this is the absolute velocity that we are getting. So continuing with our discussion, so this is the absolute velocity expression. Thus, I substitute in terms of, this is done via the center of mass. So you see therefore this equation. I discussed this equation in our last class, but it was in a hurry because we had just 1 hour class there. So I just again, explain this thing. So I just make this integration part by part, multiply everything and then distribute the integral. So I will be having four terms here, a plus b into c plus d. So it will be four terms. So it will be split into four integrals. Now, the other day I was explaining that this integration must be equal to null because it nothing but represents mass times the position vector of the center of mass with respect to the center of mass, and that definitely is equal to a null vector. So therefore it shows that this integration will be null. So if I just reverse this cross product, then if I make this v bar c out of the integration sign, then it will become minus v bar c cross integration over the mass m rho bar dm, and that will be null. So ultimately this will be a null vector. Similarly, coming back to this, you know that this expression is independent of the mass. This expression, the angular velocity of the body is also independent of the mass. So they can be taken out of the integration sign, and the integration can straight away come and hit the innermost vector, and therefore since that innermost vector integration will be null, so this result will be also equal to a null vector. So this is also a null vector, and we have this also null vector. So ultimately what we have, ultimately we will be having this. Now what is this expression? This is what will be the relative velocity of this differential mass with respect to center of mass. So that will be then is being given by this. And if you take now the cross product of this vector with this vector, then the integration over the mass m rho bar cross omega bar body cross rho bar dm will ultimately represent the relative angular momentum. It will represent the relative angular momentum with respect to the center of mass. So as a result, we can say that it should be equal to, this is equal to, I have not mentioned it to be the relative term because I have not mentioned this as to be the, whether it is relative or not, because you know from your earlier knowledge of dynamics of system of particles, you know that the absolute angular momentum and the relative angular momentum about the center of mass is basically same. So that is why it is not mentioned over here, but I will suggest you to write this within the bracket and write the symbol h bar c rel. That represents that it is the relative angular momentum with respect to the center of mass of the body. Again, I am telling that with respect to center of mass, it does not matter whether I am taking the relative momentum or it is absolute momentum. So I therefore say that with respect to any arbitrary point, the absolute angular momentum. We have found the relative angular momentum with respect to any arbitrary point in our previous article. So now, if I go to calculate the absolute angular momentum with respect to any arbitrary point, then it will be equal to what? It will be equal to the relative angular momentum about the center of mass of the body plus, this is what? This is the moment of the moment, linear momentum of the body. Because m v bar c, this represents the entire linear momentum of the body. So if you see from here, if I go back to this, then if I attach to this red vector, if I multiply this, the red vector by the mass, entire mass of the body, then m v bar c, that represents what? That represents, this is the linear momentum of this entire body at this instant. And when you are taking the cross product of r bar bar cross m v bar c, then what it would represent physically? This would physically represent the moment of, it is the moment of the total linear momentum of the body about point A. So what you basically therefore have, so let us summarize like this, what you basically you have two vectors here. Let me draw it for you, for your, this better understanding. Let me draw it for you. Suppose this is the vector that you are getting. This is the vector, say, arbitrarily ami eta dekhachi, ha eta vertically hobe emon to kono mane nei. So this is what I just change the color, say this one represents, this blue vector represents what? This represents the, it is representing the angular momentum of this body about the center of mass. Correct. This is the angular momentum of the body about the center of mass. And at the center of mass, you are having a linear momentum that is associated with this red vector. So you have two vectors here. One is h bar c, which is relative or which is absolute, does not matter. So this is h bar c. This one is representing h bar c. Eta je eta ekta onno type er vector, mane it is not the velocity vector. Shetake bojhanor jonno ami etake aro mota kore dilam. So this is the the angular momentum about the center of mass, and this is the red vector when multiplied by the entire mass of the body will give you the linear momentum of the body. Now if you try to take the moment of these two vectors with respect to point A, tale ki hobe? Assuming this is a force and this is a couple, ami jodi ebhabe jinish ta ke bhabi, this is a force vector and this is a couple vector, if we think it in that way, then we see the, if I try to calculate the moment of these two about an arbitrary point, tale ki hobe? Ei moment vector ta ja ache tai thakbe. So it will be nothing but h bar c plus, tomake ki korte hobe, khali to it you need to add, the moment of the force vector. In this case, it is the moment of the linear momentum vector about this point. So what you need to do at this point, then it will be what? It will be the sum of this vector plus moment of this vector, I mean to say moment of the linear momentum vector with respect to point A. So if I just take this and sum them up, then I will be getting an equation which is known as the angular momentum transport theorem. This is what is termed as the angular momentum transport theorem. Why it is called transport theorem? The reason it is called transport theorem is that you are transporting your momentum picture from the point of the center of mass to an arbitrary point. So that is why it is termed as, that means if you know the angular momentum of the body about the center of mass, and if you know the its velocity, I mean to say the mass of center of mass's velocity, then two things are known to you. First is the angular momentum, that is known, and the second is the linear momentum, because you just multiply with your known center of mass's velocity, multiply it by the entire mass of the body, and thus you will be getting the total linear momentum of the body. So two things are known to you, then you can transport these two vectors from the center of mass to an arbitrary point by applying this particular transport theorem. So this is basically the concept of, you know, the angular momentum that we will be requiring. So I am again reiterating, the first part that we have considered is the expression where the point O, here we took it as point O. That point O, although we specified that it will be these two points, but I kept on saying that this is an arbitrary point, and about that arbitrary set, these two are the special features. Why I say the special features? Because later part of our study, we require the special points, special cases. So that's why I make an impression in your mind that this point O is going to play an important role if this point O becomes a celebrity point in terms of the point that it will be fixed point of rotation or it will be the center of mass of the body. So we have said how we can calculate the angular momentum. We have derived to show you how you can express the relative angular momentum. Please note, এইভাবে যে অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টামটা আমরা ক্যালকুলেট করব, দিস অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম ইজ গোয়িং টু বি দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম, কারেক্ট? সো দিস উইল বি গোয়িং টু বি দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম, সো উই হ্যাভ আ রিলেশনশিপ বিটুইন দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম অ্যান্ড দি অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি অফ দি বডি। এখানে আমি খালি অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম লিখেছি, কিন্তু ইট শুড হ্যাভ বিন রিটেন অ্যাজ রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম। প্লিজ মেনশন দ্যাট ইন ইউর খাতা দ্যাট দিস ইকুয়েশন কানেক্টস ইউ the relative angular momentum about an arbitrary point on the body and the angular velocity of the body, and this is how the relationship goes. Then if I change this from the relative to absolute one, then what I will require? I require the momentum transport theorem by which we can calculate, in fact, the angular momentum of a rigid body about any arbitrary point. Any arbitrary point being given to you, you can calculate the absolute angular momentum of the rigid body about that arbitrary point. So therefore, we have the certain important things we have learned in this class, that angular momentum and angular velocity are related, and they are related via what is termed as, they are related via what is termed as the inertia matrix available over there, correct? So this is how we can set our result. Now, once this angular momentum business is over, let us now come and discuss the next important kinematic parameter, which these are all kinematic parameters. Sekhane kono force, kono moment, kichu nei kintu. So angular momentum is a kinematic parameter, as well as we are now coming to discuss what is termed as the kinetic energy of a rigid body which is moving with an arbitrary space motion. So if we consider that we have a rigid body which is moving an arbitrary, which is undergoing an arbitrary space motion, for such arbitrary space motion, we need to express, we need to evaluate what should be the kinetic energy of this rigid body. So let's say we have a kinetic energy capital T. This represents the total kinetic energy. So we have to understand what is the meaning of the total kinetic energy. Now, as I said that the rigid body is moving arbitrarily in space, it means that your body center of mass is having a linear motion. The center of mass is having a linear motion according to Chesel's theorem. Center of mass is having linear motion, and also the body is having some angular velocity. So both the two components of velocities are present for this rigid body. So that is why the body is moving, is said to be moving with an arbitrary space motion. So quite naturally then, you know, the kinetic energy of the rigid body will be expressed by this relationship. Eta kothike elo, where from you have got this expression? For that you need to remember our equation for the collection or system of particles. Tumi jano, for a system of particles, we devaluated the total kinetic energy expression. Recall our, second year first semester study, or what is called as the third semester study. So there you will see that if M sys is the system's mass of a system of, the masses, mcs multiplied by vc, c being the center of mass of the system of masses. So if I say this, and then you know that if I square it up, that it becomes v, then I just write this is 2. Sorry. So this is half m. Actually, na eta ke ei rokom bhabe likhle bodhay bhalo hoto. Let's say this is v. Just give me some time. It is c and this is square. So you see that this represents half mc vc square. This represents the total kinetic translational kinetic energy of the body. Plus, what was that? We had an expression that represents summation. You remember? তুমি যদি ওই সিস্টেম অফ মাসের ক্লাসটার খোলো, তুমি দেখবে যে দ্যাট উইল বিকাম হাফ, ইট ইজ হাফ সামেশন আই. এখানে আমরা সামটাকে দেব হচ্ছে আই ফ্রম আই ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ওয়ান টু এন. আই ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ওয়ান টু এন. দিস ইজ এম আই, দিস ইজ এম আই ইন টু, then we have v rel, this is a relative, then the relative velocity, then put the bracket, first bracket, make it once again and say this is I. So you see, this was, sorry, eta, one sec, this is I, this is 2. So this was actually the expression that we had studied in our system of mass particles. What does it say? It says that the total kinetic energy of the system is consisting of two parts. Let's make it here, bring it here on the blackboard. So you see, okay, so you see this equation. So it is the system of mass particles. So we have T equal to half mc square, mc into vc square, plus summation I from 1 to n half mi v relative I square. So this is what is termed as the translational kinetic energy due to the system of masses velocity. And this is what, this is what is termed as the kinetic energy of the system of particles because of its relative motion with respect to the center of masses. তার মানে যখন তোমার কাছে একটা সিস্টেম অফ পার্টিকেল আছে, একটা সিস্টেম অফ পার্টিকেল যখন তোমার কাছে আছে, তখন তুমি কি দেখছো যে সেই সিস্টেম অফ পার্টিকেলে তুমি দেখতে পাবে যে সেই সিস্টেম অফ পার্টিকেলে আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি যেটা, সেটা হচ্ছে ফর দ্যাট সিস্টেম অফ পার্টিকেল, ইফ আই সি দ্যাট আই হ্যাভ টু মোশনস, ওয়ান ইজ দি সেন্টার অফ মাসের জন্য একটা মোশন থাকবে, for that you will be having one kinetic energy term, and individual particles will have a relative motion with respect to the center of mass, and say relative motion er jonno, because of that relative motion you will be having some, you will be having some kinetic energy, and that kinetic energy term, you know, is expressed by this equation. Please visit your old class note to see this equation, the derivation of this equation, for your knowledge. So this is the thing that we studied in our second year first semester class when we discussed about the dynamics of system of particles. So basically we have applied that equation here. So this is the first part, no doubt, eta bojhate kono oshubidhe nei, and this is the second part. Here you see, first thing, that in summation for the system of mass particles tomar kache only n number of mass points are there. But for a rigid body, you have infinitely many mass particles. So first thing hocche ki, this sum will be therefore replaced by an integration. And individual mass, mi, will be now replaced by the differential mass. So I have therefore this half can be taken out of the integration sign. The summation is now converted to integration. Tale half take ami baire ber kore dilam, half take baire ber kore dilam. Then it, this summation I bring it integration sign, this m I make it differential mass. Now it will be the relative velocity. Now it will be the relative velocity of the individual differential mass with respect to the center of mass. Amra jani je individual mass point er relative velocity with respect to center of mass is what? This is the relative velocity of the individual mass point with respect to center of mass, right? Because this relative velocity represents the relative velocity of the individual mass particle with respect to the center of mass. As a result, instead of, in place of v relative I need to use the square of this vector. Tale ei vector ta ke amake square korte hobe. Kon vector ta ke? Omega bar body cross rho bar. This vector I need to square it up. So that is what basically I have written in this. I square what mane ki vector dutu ke dot product kore dao. Ei abar ami likhe diyechi note. Recall the relation of the group of particles. তোমার সেকেন্ড ইয়ারের ক্লাসের থেকে ফার্স্ট সেমিস্টারের ক্লাসের থেকে তুমি সেটাকে রিকল করে নাও. সো উই হ্যাভ দেয়ারফর দিস ইকুয়েশন. না আচ্ছা এটাকে আর একটু বড় করি. সো মেক ইট 125%. সো ইউ সি নাও ইফ আই এরে এটা কি হলো আচ্ছা 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 ওকে ওকে ওকে. So we now recall this ektukhani bodhay gondogol hoye geche na omega bar body cross rho bar acche darao note er moddhe ekhan tay seta eshe. Okay, so ei part ta ke tumi ignore karo, ei part ta ke ignore karo, this part we don't require. Eta kibhabe chole esche ke jane. So we now recall, so our analysis starts from here, our discussions continues from here. So we recall our vector algebra. Amra vector algebra ta ke ektu recall kori jekhane likhchi je dekho ei ta amra je vector ta ke ekhane peyechi, this can be considered as, ei je dutu vector, this can be considered as the scalar triple product. This can be considered as the scalar triple product. Ki rokom? Let us review the scalar triple product. Let us say we have three vectors a bar, b bar and c bar, such that they are represented like this. A bar dot, you can put a bracket here, first bracket, B bar cross C bar, and in that case we know the cross and dot are interchangeable. So this cross from here can go to this dot, and then this dot can be replaced by cross. So you see it becomes A bar cross B bar dot C bar. So this is a vector, this is a vector, and take a dot product. So ultimately whole thing becomes a scalar triple product. So in the above vector equation, in the above, I mean to say this, in this above case, jodi ami ekhon erokom kore jinish ta ke dhori, dekho ami ebar eta ke analogy korchi, if I take this, the first A bar vector we call it as omega bar body, B bar vector we call it as rho bar, and C bar vector we take it as omega bar body cross rho bar. Then we can write omega bar body cross rho bar dot omega bar body cross rho bar can be written as, amra tahole etake ki likhte pari, if I assume that this omega bar body is basically the what is termed as the this omega bar body cross C bar, we see that we can write like that we can say that we can interchange. কিভাবে আমরা এটা করতে পারি? We can interchange now this dot, এই ডটের সাথে এই ক্রসটাকে ইন্টারচেঞ্জ করিয়ে দিতে পারি. So we can therefore say that I call this as A bar, I call this as B bar, and I call this as C bar. So as a result I can interchange this and can write that it will be omega bar body dot. So this dot comes from here to here, this dot comes from here to here. So you have therefore what? You have therefore omega bar body dot, remaining portion ta cross hoye gelo. So you see this cross goes over there. So you see you have this particular thing. So it is omega bar body dot rho bar cross omega bar body cross rho bar. As a result you see the expression that we have. তাহলে কি হলো এখানে? এই যে এক্সপ্রেশনটা এখানে রইলো, সো আই ক্যান সে দ্যাট ইট ইজ হাফ এম ভিসি স্কোয়ার. এই ওমেগা বার বডিটাকে আমি ডট করে দিয়েছি, সো দিস ক্রস অ্যান্ড ডট ইন্টারচেঞ্জেস, So it is rho bar cross omega bar cross rho bar integration dm. And we know from our previous knowledge, that this is nothing but, what does this represent? This is nothing but the angular momentum about the center of mass. Abar, this represents the angular momentum about the center of mass. Karon ekhane kinetic energy te kintu kono arbitrary point nei. You need to take into account. Abar dekhachi ami. Ei je ekhane je equation ta ache, here the relative velocity is the relative velocity of the individual mass particle with respect to the center of mass. তাহলে এখানে অন্য কোনো কিন্তু আরবিট্রারি পয়েন্ট লাইক পয়েন্ট এ যেটা এখানে ছিল, দিস কেস ইট ইজ নো সাচ ইউ নো সিচুয়েশন এক্সিস্টস ওভার হিয়ার। সো হোয়াট এভার রিলেটিভ টার্ম ইউ আর গেটিং অল উইল নিড টু বি ক্যালকুলেটেড উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু দি সেন্টার অফ মাস, অ্যান্ড অ্যাজ এ রেজাল্ট ইউ ক্যান সে দ্যাট ইউর টোটাল এনার্জি ইজ দেয়ার ফর ডিভাইডেড ইন্টু টু কম্পোনেন্টস, ওয়ান উইল বি দিস ইউ নো দিস translational kinetic energy, one will be due to this translational kinetic energy which is half mvc square, and another is this part ei je part ta, ei part ta represent korbe hocche ki, this part represents your rotational kinetic energy. So you see the sum of these two will ultimately gives you the expression for the total kinetic energy of the body. Now you can write this translational, I mean to say the rotational kinetic energy, you can write it, it is the dot product between the two vectors ultimately. So you can write the kinetic energy, the rotational component of the kinetic energy, you can write it as T rot, the rotational component, that can be written as half omega body transpose times hc, othoba this we can write it as half omega body transpose. And remembering hc te ki bolechi ami je hc er respect e angular momentum relative o ja absolute o ta, tale considering this to be the relative angular momentum, ar amra jani in case of relative angular momentum we have the relationship between relative angular momentum and the angular velocity. Please note ei ekhane kintu eta arbitrary point, আর এইখানে কিন্তু ইট ইজ নট দি অ্যাবসোলিউট অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম, ইট ইজ দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম। সো দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম অ্যান্ড দ্য অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি, দিস টু আর রিলেটেড বাই দিস পার্টিকুলার ইকুয়েশন, অ্যান্ড হিয়ার অলসো উই আর গেটিং দিস ইজ এইচ সি। আবার আমরা জানি যে উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু সেন্টার অফ মাস উই নো দ্যাট দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম অ্যান্ড দি অ্যাবসোলিউট অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম আর বেসিক্যালি দ্য সেম। সো ট্রিটিং দিস টু বি দ্য রিলেটিভ মোমেন্টাম, I can now put the first equation and write that this can be written as half omega body transpose IC times omega body. And we need to remember that here I needs to be calculated with respect to center of mass of the body. So this is first thing that we should note, that we can write the rotational kinetic energy of a body in terms of this. Now if the body rotates only about its center of mass, that means we have the situation where the rigid body is just rotating with respect to center of mass. So neither it will, it's therefore its center of mass's linear velocity will be null because it is rotating only with respect to center of mass. Jemon ekta pulley rotate kore with respect to fixed pulley. For example, if we have a fixed pulley, then the fixed pulley is rotating with respect to center of mass. বা তুমি ধরো একটা বড় ড্রাম, এ সিলিন্ড্রিক্যাল ড্রাম ফিক্সড ইন টু বেয়ারিংস ইজ রোটেটিং অ্যাবাউট ইটস ওন অ্যাক্সিস, দেন দিস টাইপ অফ মোশন আর দি কেসেস ওয়্যার দ্য বডি ইজ রোটেটিং উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু দি সেন্টার অফ মাস ইটসেলফ। সো ইফ আন্ডার সাচ সার্কামস্টেন্সেস উই নো দ্যাট দি সেন্টার অফ মাস উইল নট হ্যাভ এনি ভেলোসিটি হোয়াটসএভার। So therefore, the translational part of the kinetic energy term in the total kinetic energy in this equation, you see the translational kinetic energy terms totally becomes zero. So the entire kinetic energy thus becomes equal to the rotational kinetic energy, and that too it is with respect to center of mass, and therefore I can write the total kinetic energy of such body can be given by this particular expression. Now if I think that the body is rotating about a fixed point, now that is very interesting thing. if a body is rotating about a fixed point, say in that case, what will happen? So for example, we consider, let us say, this is the body and the body is rotating with respect to the point A. No need to take into account the center of mass, because every particle on this body, because this is the point of rotation. So every particle on this body, say for example, if we take a different, an arbitrary mass particle, right? This is an arbitrary mass particle. So this arbitrary mass particle will have a velocity v bar, where how we will be writing this expression v bar. So we can say, we can write that expression of v bar. For example, ami eta tomake kore dekhachi. Please give me some time to write the expression. So the v bar becomes equal to what? Now it should be omega bar. So I write it here for you. This will be omega bar. Ami khali body ta purota na likhe ami omega b liklam. Thik ache? Omega b mane hocche omega body. So it is omega bar. Just giving its vector flavor, I put bar. Then it will be the cross product, and then it will be r bar. R bar is the position vector of that arbitrary dm mass with respect to the point of rotation. So if this is the case, this is the velocity, then what will be the kinetic energy? The kinetic energy is definitely equal to, what will be the kinetic energy expression? That kinetic energy amra ki likhte pari, egulo kintu khatay lekho, ha? This kinetic energy expression will be equal to what? So this will be integration. Ami to dekhte pacchi na tumi likhcho ki likhcho na, but please write it down, because otherwise it will not be there in your note. So it is half, you know, this. Now it will be v bar square. So v square. So this v square. So v square mane ki amra eta ke likhte pari v bar dot v bar. Tar mane ultimately ki likhte pari, we can write this expression. I can write this expression, put it in a bracket. This is a complete vector dot. This needs to be dotted with, again, the same thing. That means it needs to be taken with respect to this. And this entire process needs to be, you know, this is the integration that you will be having. Right? Now, look at the similarity. Earlier, you had here rho bar, which is the position vector of the arbitrary mass with respect to the center of mass. Now, since your body is rotating about the fixed point, so any particle on the body will have a velocity, absolute velocity. Any particle will be having the absolute velocity that will be expressed by this. And since this is the absolute velocity, tar mane ki amra ekhane ekta step amader hoyto arekta likhle bhalo hoto tomader jonno. Seta hocche ki t should be equal to ki likhte hoto amake ekhane, amake just likhte hoto ei jinish ta. Ami dekhachi. What I need to write is this equation. Half, I should have written it v square. So what I should have written, that this I should have written like this. This will be, and in front of it we should have an integration sign. Tai na? Ekantate amader ekta integration sign thakto. This is your mass m over this mass m. Tale ei integration ta amar thakto. Now, because this v bar represents the absolute velocity, tale amake erokom kore square kore, and had I made this integration over the entire domain, I would have got the kinetic energy, total kinetic energy. Now in place of v, I just substitute. Now v square can be written as v bar dot v bar, and that can be written as like this. So ultimately, tahole ki daralo? Ultimately daralo, this becomes now what? This becomes now half. Ki daralo jinish ta? Now we can write this is half. This will be omega, I just write it quickly. This will be this, take the dot. So the rest is bakita jeta. Okay. I take this. Bakita jeta, a integration tar ekhon ar amar dorkar nei. Ami eta kore felechi. So this should have been written like this, that it is dot, this is h bar a. So this should be equal to you know, H bar. So this is H bar A. So this would be equal to half omega bar body dot H bar A, where H bar A is the angular momentum about the fixed point of rotation. এবার ফিক্সড পয়েন্ট অফ রোটেশনের অ্যাবসলিউট অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম ও যা রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম ওটা বিকজ ইট ডাজ নট হ্যাভ এনি ওন ভেলোসিটি রিলেটিভ ভেলোসিটি কখন থাকবে যখন পয়েন্ট এর একটা নিজস্ব ভেলোসিটি থাকবে সো ইফ এ ইজ এ ফিক্সড পয়েন্ট অফ রোটেশন ইট ডাজ নট হ্যাভ এনি ভেলোসিটি সো দি অ্যাবসলিউট অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম অ্যান্ড দ্য রিলেটিভ অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম রিমেইনস দ্য সেম তাহলে তাই যদি হয় তাহলে এগেইন উই ক্যান রাইট দিস এক্সপ্রেশন তাহলে আমরা কি লিখতে পাচ্ছি So we can say copy. Amra tahole we can write like this. Now I write this in you know the what is termed as I now write this omega. Sorry, I write it in terms of the you know this matrix format. So I say this is half omega b. This is transpose. Then we write I. Then we will be writing third bracket I. So third bracket I and this I needs to be calculated with respect to point A. হ্যাঁ বোধহয় কিছু একটা উৎসব বলছিল বলো কি
বলছিলাম স্যার বলছিলাম এই ওমেগা বডি ট্রান্সপোজটা কেন হয় একটু বলবেন
ও এটা তো তোমার ভেক্টর প্রোডাক্টের জন্য এই যে তুমি এবার ডট বিবার তুমি যখন কোন একটা ভেক্টর এবার কে কলাম ম্যাট্রিক্সে লিখছো এবার ডট বিবার এবার ইকুয়াল টু হচ্ছে এক্স এ ওয়াই এ জেড বি হচ্ছে বিবার হচ্ছে বি এক্স বি ওয়াই বি জেড দুটো কলাম ম্যাট্রিক্স এবার এই দুটো কলাম ম্যাট্রিক্স কে তুমি একটা স্কেলার লিখতে চাইছো সো ইট ইজ ওয়ান বাই ওয়ান তাহলে সেই স্কেলারটাকে লিখবে কি করে ওয়ান বাই থ্রি ডট থ্রি বাই ওয়ান তাহলে এক বাই থ্রি কে থ্রি বাই ওয়ান এর সাথে মাল্টিপ্লাই করতে হবে তাহলে ওয়ান বাই থ্রি কি করে পাবে ইট ওয়াজ অরিজিনালি থ্রি বাই ওয়ান তাহলে ওয়ান বাই থ্রি পেতে গেলে থ্রি বাই ওয়ান কে ট্রান্সপোজ করতে হবে সো ইট উইল বি ট্রান্সপোজ ডট অরিজিনাল ভেক্টর সো ইফ উই হ্যাভ এবার ডট বিবার তাহলে আমরা লিখতে পারি কি এবার ডট বিবার মানে কি দ্যাট ইজ ইকুয়াল টু হচ্ছে এ ট্রান্সপোজ বি ইন্টু বি তাই না সুতরাং ওইটাকে ট্রান্সপোজ করা হয়েছে তাই আই টেক দি ট্রান্সপোজ অফ দিস ভেক্টর And then multiply this vector, and I write this particular equation. So you see, therefore, ki bujhte parecho, Shibnath?
Yes, sir. Thik ache, sir.
Bujhte parecho. Ake arekbar bolbo.
Na, sir. Bujhe gechi. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So you have 1 by 3 into 3 by 1. Kore tumi ekta scalar pabe 1 by 1. Tumake oi matrix er multiplication algorithm ta ke follow korte hobe. So as a result, you can see therefore. In case your body rotates about a fixed point, then your total kinetic energy will be written as half omega body transpose times I about point A omega B. Ekhane ekta jinish khub important. Here your I needs to be calculated with respect to the point of rotation. Tai na? Tale je point er respect e tumi angular momentum nichcho, sei point er respect e kintu you need to evaluate your inertia matrix term. So it will be written in this manner. So therefore, I see in your note sheet, I simply just write. আমি অবশ্য পয়েন্ট এটাকে আমি এখানে পয়েন্ট এ বলে লিখলাম এটা দেখা যাচ্ছে নোটে ও হিসেবে লেখা আছে তাহলে টু অ্যাভয়েড দি কনফিউশন আমি এখানে দু জায়গাতেই ও করে দিই সো দ্যাট দেয়ার উইল বি নো কনফিউশন সো ইউ সি দিস ইজ হাউ ইউ ক্যান রাইট ও ইজ দি পয়েন্ট অফ রোটেশন About which fixed point of rotation. O is the fixed point of rotation about which your body is rotating. Under such circumstances, you see your total kinetic energy has to be given by this. And again, here it is written I needs to be found at the center of rotation or the fixed point or the point O. So, this is how you can calculate the angular momentum and the kinetic energy of a rigid body. তাহলে বোঝা গেল জিনিসটা কিভাবে আমরা কাইনেটিক এনার্জি এবং কিভাবে আমরা অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম দিস টু আর দি ইম্পর্টেন্ট টার্মস কাইনেমেটিক টার্মস দ্যাট উই নিড টু স্টাডি ওয়ান্স ইট ইজ ডান উই ক্যান নাও কাম অ্যান্ড ডিসকাস ফিউ প্রবলেমস তাহলে লেট আস সি দ্য ফার্স্ট প্রবলেম Okay. So this is the first problem that we will be having. What is this problem saying? The problem is saying something like this. We have a disk here, disk of mass M and radius capital R. The disk is homogeneous and there is a yoke. Eta hocche amader yoke ta. Ei je. This is the yoke. The yoke is carrying the bearing of the disk. The bearing of the disk is at point C, right? Yoke is massless. Mane ba amra ebhabe bolte pari je compared to the mass of this disk, this mass of the yoke is very very small, and the entire yoke is rigidly connected to a massless shaft. The shaft is rotating about its own axis with an angular velocity of omega 1. At the instant shown, this is the configuration of the system, right? Where the center line is, you know, at a height h above the center line of the shaft, and the disk is able to rotate with respect to its bearing with an angular velocity whose magnitude is p. So the disk is rotating about its bearing with this angular velocity, and we have some axes which are being given. This is the x axis, this is the y axis, this is the z axis. These are being rigidly connected to the center of the disk C, so that it is for our purpose we will be able to evaluate our total angular velocity of the body. Tale ekhane amader body ta konta? This is the entire system. Please note, this is the entire system. Ei entire system er moddhe body ta konta? Body hocche that component which possesses mass, and what is that? That is this disk. So the disk is our body for this entire system. What we need to calculate is, we need to calculate the angular momentum about the center of mass of this disk C. So you need to calculate the angular momentum here. Then you need to calculate angular momentum about the point A. See, this is point A, which is a fixed point. But can it be fixed axis of point of rotation? Can I think that this mass, I mean to say the disk, is rotating about this point? Bolo, ei disk ta ki ei point er about e rotate korbe? The answer is no. Why? Because the angular velocity of the disk, dekho ei particular instance, the angular velocity of the disk about this is about this z axis. Ei dike amar angular velocity ta royeche, ar ei disk ta ghurche erokom bhabe, tar mane er angular velocity royeche hocche kon dike? Ei dike. Ei dutu angular velocity ke if I sum, so one angular velocity is this, another angular velocity is this. These two vectors are the skew vectors. Ei dutu vector hocche skew vector. Either resultant will never pass through point A. Ei disk ta ke if it is to rotate with respect to point A, etake jodi rotate korte hoy with respect to point A, then the total or the actual angular velocity of the body, omega body, you remember, it is the absolute angular velocity of the body. That absolute angular velocity vector needs to pass through the point A, which in this case is not. Though A vector ta A point e diye jacche, this vector, I mean to say the vector which is the angular velocity of the disk, this is not going through point A. If I make this h to be 0, limit h tends to 0, then definitely this vector will pass through point A. Then that would be the case, will be the, at a hypothetical case of A, of course, that will be the case when the body will be rotating about this fixed point. So it is, although the point A is not having any velocity, please note, the point A is not having any velocity, still we cannot consider that this is a point about which this rigid body is rotating. So as a result of this, etar jehetu etar about e ami likhte parchi na, so I need to be cautious when I will be writing the angular momentum about point A. So we need to calculate the angular momentum about point A, then we need to calculate the kinetic energy of the system. Tar mane amra ei chapter e je je jinish gulo shikechi, everything needs to be applied, ar ei gulo prottektai ami ekhan theke bar korte pari. Tar amra ektu khani onko ta dekheni. So let us fix up the xyz inertial frame এই ইনার্শিয়াল এই অঙ্কটা আমি একটু ডিটেইলে করেছি কারণ দিস ইজ দি ফার্স্ট সাম আফটার লং গ্যাপ সো উই হ্যাভ এক্স ওয়াই জেড ইনার্শিয়াল ফ্রেম হুইচ ইজ ফিক্সড অ্যাবাউট পয়েন্ট এ এবং দিস আর ইওর অ্যাক্সিস সে দিস ইজ ক্যাপিটাল ওয়াই অ্যাক্সিস ইজ দিস ওয়ে ক্যাপিটাল ওয়াই অ্যাক্সিস ইজ দিস ওয়ে ক্যাপিটাল এক্স অ্যাক্সিস ইজ দিস ওয়ে অ্যান্ড ক্যাপিটাল জেড অ্যাক্সিস উইল বি ডেফিনেটলি এক্স ক্রস ওয়াই ইজ ক্যাপিটাল জেড সো ক্যাপিটাল জেড উইল বি দিস ওয়ে সো অ্যাট দিস ইনস্ট্যান্ট আওয়ার ইনার্শিয়াল রেফারেন্স আওয়ার বডি নন ইনার্শিয়াল রেফারেন্স ফ্রেম এই যে স্মল এক্স ওয়াই জেড এই স্মল এক্স ওয়াই জেডটাকে কোথায় আমি অ্যাটাচ করেছি ইট ইজ রিজিডলি ক্ল্যাম্পড অ্যাট দি সেন্টার অফ দ্য ডিস্ক তার মানে এই এক্স ওয়াই জেডটাকে আমি ক্ল্যাম্প করে দিয়েছি কোথায় ডিস্কের সেন্টারে তাহলে দিস এক্স ওয়াই জেড উইল বি ডেফিনেটলি চেঞ্জিং দেয়ার ওরিয়েন্টেশনস বাট অ্যাট দিস ইনস্ট্যান্ট রিপ্রেজেন্টেটেড আই সি দ্যাট ক্যাপিটাল এক্স আর স্মল এক্স আর শেয়ারিং দ্য সেম ডাইরেকশন স্মল ওয়াই ক্যাপিটাল ওয়াই শেয়ারিং দ্য সেম ডাইরেকশন স্মল জেড অ্যান্ড ক্যাপিটাল জেড আর শেয়ারিং দ্য সেম ডাইরেকশন ক্যাপিটাল এক্স ওয়াই জেড উইল নেভার চেঞ্জ ইটস ওরিয়েন্টেশন বাট স্মল এক্স ওয়াই জেড উইল চেঞ্জ ইটস ওরিয়েন্টেশন বিকজ অফ দ্য মোশন অফ দ্য রোটেশন অফ দিস ডিস্ক সো অ্যাজ এ রেজাল্ট আই ক্যান দেয়ার ফোর ফাইন্ড দ্যাট দি অ্যাবসোলিউট অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি অফ দি ডিস্ক সেটা কি হবে Now that will be the relative angular velocity of the disk with respect to the center of mass plus the center of mass's own velocity, angular velocity. So you see therefore that these two velocities needs to be combined with each other and can be written as this is the reference frame's angular velocity. I mean to say the angular velocity of this small xyz reference frame that is being given by omega 1 capital J cap. প্লাস কারণ আমরা কোথায় লিখেছি দেখো এক্স ওয়াই জেড হচ্ছে রিজিডলি অ্যাটাচড ও আই এম সরি এটা সেন্টার অফ দ্য ডিস্ক হবে না সরি এটা একটু ভুল হয়েছে দিস ইজ নট দি সেন্টার অফ দ্য ডিস্ক ইট শুড বি অবশ্য একই কথা তুমি কোথা যেখানেই রাখো আমি যেভাবে ইন্টারপ্রেট করছিলাম তাতে এটা সেন্টার অফ দ্য ডিস্কে থাকে না যাই হোক এটা থাকবে হচ্ছে এক্স ওয়াই জেড ইজ রিজিডলি অ্যাটাচ টু দি বেয়ারিং অফ দ্য ইয়ক এই ইয়কের বেয়ারিং এ এই সেন্টারে এই এক্স ওয়াই জেডটাকে আমি আটকেছি নট এট দি সেন্টার অফ দ্য ডিস্ক এই ডিস্কের সেন্টারে নয় এই ডিস্কের সেন্টারটা কাটা হ্যাঁ এইটা কাটা বলো হ্যাঁ বলো বলো
পিটা পিটা কি ছিল পিটা কি ছিল
পিটা ছিল হচ্ছে ডিস্কের অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা পি আচ্ছা ডিস্কের অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ
ডিস্কের অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি হচ্ছে তোমার পি তাহলে এই আর এই বেয়ারিংটার এই যে বেয়ার এই যে ইয়কের যে সি পয়েন্টটা এই সি পয়েন্টে আমি এটা ডিস্ক হবে না এটা উইল বি অন দা ইয়ক এই ইয়কের উপরে আমি এই এক্স ওয়াই জেডটাকে লাগিয়ে দেব তাহলে তাহলে রেফারেন্স ফ্রেমটার অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি হয়ে যাবে কি দিস ওমেগা ওয়ান কারণ এই ইয়কটা ডাইরেক্টলি কানেক্টেড হয়েছে শ্যাফটের সাথে সো দি রেফারেন্স ফ্রেমস অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি উইল বি ইকুয়াল টু ওমেগা ওয়ান বার So you have therefore omega 1 bar plus the relative angular velocity of the disk that is P bar. So you can therefore say right it is omega 1 capital J cap plus P K cap that can be written as ultimately because your J bar and small J bar are instantaneously same. So I can therefore write this to be equal to omega 1 small J cap plus P small K cap. So this is how you can therefore find out the angular velocity of the disk. This is the absolute angular velocity of the disk. বোঝা গেল জিনিসটা আরেকবার বলে দিচ্ছি. How we are doing? We are fixing this XYZ reference frame to the center of this yoke which carries the bearing of the wheel. The bearing or rather the disk or the wheel is able to freely rotate with respect to its bearing. So this angular velocity will be the relative angular velocity with respect to any person who is sitting on the small xyz reference frame and what where the small xyz reference frame is attached the small xyz reference frame is attached at the point C of the yoke so you need to calculate the small xyz reference frame's own angular velocity which will be the angular velocity that will be created at the yoke because of the rotation of the shaft so that's why you have this is the angular velocity of the reference frame plus the relative angular velocity of the body ultimately written in this fashion. So you see therefore that your omega body is having, this is the vector instantaneously. And I told you in the class, you remember, all your expressions need to be found in along the instantaneous axis, not along the inertial axis. So all these things needs to be calculated with respect to small xyz axis, because they are continuously changing, right? So that is why, you know, that they have to be expressed in terms in along all those instantaneous axis. So I therefore see, now I write the equation with respect to center of mass. It is altogether same whether it is relative or whether it is absolute. So I can therefore see, I write this hc equal to ic times omega body, and ic will be equal to what? This disk is a plate like body. So now you see je amra age chapter e pore eschi, if it is a plate like body, then all the product moment of inertia, and it is symmetric, all the product moment of inertia terms are zero, and therefore this axis will become the principal axis of inertia for this plate like body. And I have therefore ixx, which will be equal to 1/4 mr square, iyy, that will be equal to 1/4 mr square, and izz, here the parallel axis, sorry, perpendicular axis theorem is valid because it is a small body. So I can write izz equal to ixx plus iyy. এটা যদি সিলিন্ডার হয়ে যেত, লম্বা একটা সিলিন্ডার হতো, আই কুড নট রাইট izz equal to ixx plus iyy. Be very careful. So as a result, I have, this will be our inertia matrix term. So all the principal diagonal terms are present, off diagonal terms are all zero. And since your omega body does not have any x component, so it is zero omega 1 p. So if you just carry out this matrix multiplication, it gives you the angular momentum about point C given by this, and finally you can write your angular momentum. It does not have any x component, but it has definitely y component, and you, it had the z component. So as a result, you see this h bar c can be expressed in this fashion, right? This is a simple task for you to write it. So the first part of the problem is over, where we have been asked to find out the angular momentum about the point C. Now we are told to find out the angular momentum about point A. Please remember, here I cannot write angular momentum about A is given by sort of expression like this. I cannot write it to be as IA times omega body. I cannot write. Why I cannot write? Because about this point A, this body is not rotating. Had it been found to be rotating about this point, I could have written the angular momentum of the body about point A, right, like this equation. Tale ekhane amake ki korte hobe? Then you need to find out, if I have to find out the angular momentum about this point, just I need to apply the angular momentum transport theorem, which states that for applying the angular momentum transport theorem, we should be knowing two things. First is the angular momentum of the body with respect to the center of mass, seta ki ami jani. Second, whether I know the linear momentum of the body calculated at the center of mass. Tale amake ki korte hobe? I need to find out two things: angular momentum of the body about the center of mass, and I need to find out the linear velocity of the center of mass. Tar mane dekho, amra already ager part tate, part 1 e amra kintu angular momentum about the center of mass bar kore felechi. Tahole for the second case, I need, before writing the transport theorem from this point to this point, I need to know what should be the velocity of point C. Now it is very simple. Since point C is belonging to this Yawk center, therefore C's velocity is only created because of the motion about point, because of the motion due to omega 1. A omega 1 er jonnoi kintu C er velocity thakbe. Otherwise P এর জন্য তো C এর কোনো ভেলোসিটি থাকবে না. So C is said to is actually rotating with respect to point A about a circle যার সেন্টার হচ্ছে at point A and whose radius is h. So what I need to therefore see, that the center of C's velocity is being given by ओमेगा वन बार क्रॉस आर बार r bar c relative to a. This means the position vector of c relative to a. So I need to find out the position vector of c relative to point a, and then that omega 1 bar cross that position vector will directly give me the center of masses velocity. So therefore you see the omega 1 bar is written as omega 1 j cap, capital J cap, and r bar c relative to a, this vector is not along capital X. Why it is not along capital X? Because after some time this configuration will change. So capital X will remain vertical. Say delta t time bade ki hobe, it will be inclined na, eta tomar right side e inclined hoye jabe because of the omega 1 velocity, right? So tale as a result your this position vector will no longer be vertical, kintu capital X kintu sob shomoy vertical hoye thakbe. So actually key, now this velocity we can say, because this axis is instantaneous axis, it is instantaneous, so I can say the instantaneous position vector of c relative to a is nothing but small h small I cap. So this is small h small I cap. Eigulo amra detail e kintu second year first semester e porechhilam. So just recall our discussion over there. So you see you need to take the cross product between the two, and since capital J cap is instantaneously aligned with small j cap, I transfer this capital J to small j and write this and express my result in terms of the instantaneous coordinate system. So ultimately I find therefore that the center of masses velocity is being given by h omega 1 k cap with a minus sign. This you can also physically verify. Because of this omega 1, the center of masses velocity will be, because this is going like this na, eta ei bhabe chole asche, so as a result you see the c point's velocity will be, you know, the, because of this motion it will be along in this direction. As a result of that you see this c's velocity you can find out in this manner. So once this is done you can see now, go on putting this expression, and you see that this is the transport theorem basically we are applying. This is the transport theorem that we are applying here, and in this case we see from here that jodi amra ekhane transport theorem ta ke ekhane apply kori tahole amra ki dekhte pacchi na, we are getting this and taking the cross product on everything, we find that we are having the angular momentum about point A is given by this particular expression. Ei expression ta diye amra angular momentum about point A peye jabo. Finally pore thaklo ki, finally pore thaklo hocche kinetic energy. That will be our last part. Ere, where goes the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy ta kothay korlam? Ulto palta hoye gelo naki? E baba. পুরো ছবিটাই উল্টে গেছে যা
ও
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে আমি মুখে বলে দিচ্ছি কাইনেটিক এনার্জির এক্সপ্রেশনটা যা কি হয়েছে এটাকে আবার ঠিকঠাক করে ছবি তুলে পাঠাতে হবে আমাকে দেখছি সরি এখানে কাইনেটিক এনার্জি টার্মটা নেই তাহলে কাইনেটিক এনার্জির এক্সপ্রেশনটা কি হবে এখানে বিকজ ইউ সি দি সেন্টার অফ মাস ইজ হ্যাভিং দ্য ভেলোসিটি. So the kinetic energy will be the full kinetic energy. I mean to say it will have the translational part of the kinetic energy as well as it will have the rotational part also. Tai na, rotational part ebong translational part duto party hocche kintu ekhantate thakbe. So both will be present over there. Acha ami na ekhanta ekta bhul korechi bujhle. এই ভুলটা একটুখানি প্লিজ চেক ইওর ওমেগা 1 আমার ধারণা এটা ওমেগা 1 জে ক্যাপ এটা এই অ্যারোটা না ভুল দেখানো আছে সরি এই ওমেগা 1 জে ক্যাপটা এটা এই দিকে হবে সরি দিস উইল বি এই দিকে হবে সরি প্লিজ চেক ইট হ্যাঁ এটা একটু চেক করে নাও কারণ আমরা ওমেগা 1 টাকে ব্যবহার করেছি ওমেগা 1 জে ক্যাপ ক্যাপিটাল জে ক্যাপ হিসেবে পজিটিভ জে ক্যাপ দেখিয়েছিলাম পজিটিভ জে ক্যাপ মানে এই দিকে ক্যাপিটাল ওয়াইটা এই দিকে ছিল সরি এই অ্যারোটা এই লাল অ্যারোটাকে এগুলো সব ঠিক করে আমাকে আমি এক্ষুনি তোমাকে এই ক্লাস নোটটা পাঠাচ্ছি না মানে নিউমেরিক্যাল এক্সাম্পলটা পাঠাচ্ছি না এটা আমাকে আরেকবার ছবি তুলে পাঠাতে হবে এই জায়গাটা ঠিক করে সো দিস অ্যারো উইল বি দ্য রিভার্স ডাইরেকশন প্লিজ নোট এই অ্যারোটা রিভার্স ডাইরেকশন থাকবে সরি সো এগেইন ওকে তাহলে ঠিকই আছে বাকি সব নাও ইন অর্ডার টু ফাইন্ড আউট দি টোটাল কাইনেটিক এনার্জি অফ দি সিস্টেম হোয়াট আই রিকোয়ার I require the kinetic and total kinetic energy that will be equal to half mvc square. দেখো আমরা vc পেয়ে গেছি this is v bar c এই যে v bar c এখানে ক্যালকুলেটেড হয়ে গিয়েছে so this is v bar c where we have calculated the center of masses velocity v bar c so that has been calculated already and I know the angular momentum about the center of mass And I also know the total angular velocity of the kinetic energy. So please write in your khata. I just dictate. Quickly write. Lekho. Prottekke. So the total kinetic energy of the system, KE of the system, is equal to capital T. capital T is equal to half mvc square, half mvc square, plus half plus half কি আসছে না ওমেগা বার বডি ডট ওমেগা বার বডি ডট h বার c half mvc square plus half ওমেগা বার বডি ডট h বার c ঠিক আছে that will be our kinetic energy of the system now vc is already found So, V bar C is known to be equal to minus H omega 1 k cap, right? Minus H1 H omega 1 k cap. That means V C square হবে H square omega 1 square. তার সাথে m গুণ করে দাও। তাহলে প্রথম পার্টটা হয়ে গেল কি? It is equal to half. পরের লাইনে লেখো, it is equal to half m H square omega 1 square. ঠিক আছে? Half m H square plus omega 1 square plus এবারে হাফ কি করব না আমরা দুটো জিনিস করব একটা হচ্ছে অ্যাঙ্গুলার মোমেন্টাম ভেক্টরের সাথে আমরা ওমেগা বার বডিকে ডট করে দেব তাহলে এইচ বার সি কি ছিল লেখো প্লাস দিয়ে লেখো পরের পার্টটা মানে রোটেশনাল কাইনেটিক এনার্জিটা হাফ ইনটু এম আর স্কোয়ার বাই ফোর তাহলে হাফ ইনটু এম আর স্কোয়ার বাই ফোরও লিখতে পারো অথবা তুমি এম আর স্কোয়ার বাই এইট লিখতে পারো হোয়াট এভার So half into mr square by 4 into first bracket open omega 1 j cap plus 2 p k cap omega 1 j cap plus 2 p k cap dot এইবারে আমাদের কি করতে হবে omega bar body কে dot করতে হবে তাহলে omega bar body কি ছিল omega 1 j cap plus p k cap তাহলে কি দাঁড়ালো সেকেন্ড পার্টটা আরেকবার বলছি সেকেন্ড পার্টটা দাঁড়ালো হচ্ছে হাফ এম আর স্কোয়ার বাই ফোর হোল ইনটু ওমেগা ওয়ান জে ক্যাপ প্লাস টু পি কে ক্যাপ ডট ওমেগা ওয়ান জে ক্যাপ প্লাস পি কে ক্যাপ নাও বাকিটা তুমি নিজে করে ফেলতে পারবে টেক দি ডট প্রোডাক্ট সাম দেম অ্যাড দেম অল বিকজ কাইনেটিক এনার্জি ইজ এ স্কেলার এক্সপ্রেশন সো ইট উইল নট হ্যাভ এনি আই জে কে আনসার সো ইট উইল বি এ বিগ স্কেলার এক্সপ্রেশন that you can get very easily from
sir
bolo
so mr square by 8 into omega 1 j cap মানে ডট করে সেকেন্ড এক্সপ্রেশনটা কি ছিল স্যার ওটা ভুলে গেছি
তোমাকে কি বললাম এই জন্য বলেছি খাতা বার করে সব সময় লিখবে না হলে গন্ডগোল হয়ে যাবে কিন্তু আমি কি বলেছি রোটেশনাল কাইনেটিক এনার্জির এক্সপ্রেশনটা কি ছিল রোটেশনাল কাইনেটিক এনার্জির এক্সপ্রেশন হোয়াট ওয়াজ দা রোটেশনাল কাইনেটিক এনার্জি এক্সপ্রেশন এই যে আমরা এখানে কি দেখালাম এই যে হাফ ওমেগা বার বডি ডট এইচ বার সি হ্যাঁ দিস ইজ দা থিং তাহলে আমরা এটাকে লিখতে পারতাম কি হাফ এইচ বার সি ডট ওমেগা বার বডি একই কথা হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ তাই না তাহলে এখানে কি ছিল এখানে আমরা কি দেখলাম এখানে হোয়াট উই সি আমরা দেখেছি যে এইচ বার সি ইজ দিস তাহলে হাফ এইচ বার সি মানে হাফ এম আর স্কোয়ার বাই ফোর হোল ইন টু ওমেগা ওয়ান জে ক্যাপ প্লাস টু পি কে ক্যাপ তার সাথে ডট করতে হবে টোটাল অ্যাঙ্গুলার ভেলোসিটি অফ দি বডি হুইচ ইজ গিভেন বাই ওমেগা ওয়ান জে ক্যাপ প্লাস পি কে ক্যাপ। তাহলে এই ভেক্টর এমআর স্কোয়ার হাফ এমআর স্কোয়ার বাই ফোর ইন্টু ওমেগা ওয়ান জে ক্যাপ প্লাস টু পি কে ক্যাপ ডট ওমেগা ওয়ান জে ক্যাপ প্লাস পি কে ক্যাপ। তার আগে রয়ে গেছে কিন্তু তার আগে রয়ে গেছে ট্রান্সলেশনাল কাইনেটিক এনার্জিটা, দ্যাট ইজ হাফ এম ভিসি স্কোয়ার, মানে হাফ এম এইচ এ স্কোয়ার ওমেগা ওয়ান স্কোয়ার। এই যে ভিসি ইজ এইচ ইন্টু মাইনাস এইচ ইন্টু ওমেগা ওয়ান কে ক্যাপ, তাহলে হাফ এম ভিসি স্কোয়ার হচ্ছে হাফ এম এইচ এ স্কোয়ার ওমেগা ওয়ান স্কোয়ার প্লাস ওই টার্মটা। ঠিক আছে, তো ডু দিস সিম্পলিফিকেশন অ্যান্ড মেক ইট দিস রেজাল্ট। ঠিক আছে, তো টুডে উইল স্টপ হিয়ার আপ টু রাইট অ্যাট দিস পয়েন্ট বিকজ ইউ হ্যাভ নেক্সট ক্লাস অ্যান্ড টিকেন স্যার হ্যাজ রিকোয়েস্টেড মি টু লিভ ইউ আর্লি অ্যান্ড আই ডু নট হ্যাভ দ্য সাফিসিয়েন্ট টাইম টু ডিসকাস দ্য নেক্সট প্রবলেম। সো হোয়াট আই উইল ডু, আই উইল রেক্টিফাই, এখানে একটু ভুল হয়েছে, এই অ্যারোটাকে ঠিক করে দিতে হবে। And also the, I think the picture capture is also not very good, proper, we have to correct it. So all these things will be done, but after the puja. So I'll be not sending this part of the class note to you. On the other hand, I will be sending you the angular momentum part and the angular momentum, the second part also, I'll be sending to you. Say by tomorrow, I'll sending this two class notes to your WhatsApp group, but this I will send after discussing the remaining problems, and that will be done after the puja break. So after the puja break, we will be assembling here again on 2nd of November, because that is on Monday, and Monday we are having scheduled class. So on the scheduled time, we will be meeting on 2nd November. The class link will be sent to you in due course. So if you have any question, feel free to ask me. Or otherwise, I will stop recording the class because I have today recorded the class. I do not know Srinjoy has entered the class, whether he is recording or not. Anyway, I have recorded the class. Korecho? Wow, very good. Wow, wow, wow. Fantastic. Okay, thik ache. Tale ami amar recording ta ke ekhane bondho kore di. And I will also send my recording copy to you if you like. Or I will keep it in my record. Acha chat box e dekha jacche. Okay Shravan, please ekta 20